Hey folks, Carl Kuster here. This is one of our fleet sleds from last year. It's got about 2,500 kilometers on it. We're just gonna kind of go from the front of it to the back and go over some of the wear items and some of the maintenance things that you could look at before you start this season. So the first thing we're gonna kind of look at is ski rubbers. And they're a wearable item. So when you're checking the ski rubber, what you wanna look for is any signs of cracking, if the rubber looks pounded out or wide. This one looks like it's in pretty good shape. There's a little bit of play in there, which is about normal. And the reason you'd want to change those is because it keeps the snowmobile up on top, planing on the snow, and it doesn't do this with the skis. And then actually that's where the back end will wash out. If you put, you know, a fair amount of pressure and the ski comes all the way up to here, well, then that's definitely time to change it. You can see this rubber is in pretty nice shape. There's no cracking, there's no distortion. It's still as it would be from new. So you can see the carbide is nice and straight, or the skeg is nice and straight. If they're bent, change them. You can look in here and see there's actually no chips. The carbide is one continuous piece. I'll show you one though that probably should be changed, and that's this guy. So that thing kind of looks like a hockey stick. You've got a big wow. Carbides are all busted apart. If you're gonna ride early or late, you're probably gonna change one or two of those in your career. So next, we're gonna have a little look at the clutches. We try and blow our clutches out every other ride, or if it's really deep powder, we blow them out every ride. This is gonna give you the best performance and the most longevity. There's a little bit of belt residue on there. Pop your belt off. So just slide it off from around the front, turn it sideways. You can see how it just cleans that off. Make sure you do a lap around here, clean the secondary clutch, and I also do the belt. It's just basically on the sides. You don't have to worry about the top. Make sure it looks nice and uniform. That's a good looking belt. There's a few different ways to check belt tension. And one way to do it is if the bottom of the cogs are flush with the top of the secondary clutch. But the important thing is you don't want the snowmobile to creep. So when you start it, when the belt's cold, that it wants to move the snowmobile. The less deflection you have, the more direct it is from your thumb to the track. When you run a nice snug, not too tight, but you run a snug belt deflection, it improves the creepability of the sled, or basically to creep on top of the snow or walk on top of the snow. The next thing we can actually check is chain tension. And when the chain is brand new, in the first 500 miles or 800 kilometers, is when it stretches the most. You can see the clutch rocks without moving the drive shaft. So when you're adjusting your chain tension, use this clever little tool off the belt guards, and it's got a T30 Torx on there. You'll feel once it starts to have some tension, that's it. It's actually just finger tight like that. You'll be able to tell, and you rock the secondary, it's quite firm. Still has a little bit of play, and that's all you're looking for. Once the chain is broke in, it really doesn't require a ton of maintenance. If the track tension is too loose, it'll skip inside the drivers when there's heavy snow, and if it's too tight, you'll be robbing power. There's a fancy tool you can use. I have this set at 15 pounds and 30 millimeters, and I push down, and when that hits 15 pounds, this O-ring is exactly here. It gives me 30 millimeters of play. Now, if you don't have that, no big deal. This piece of plastic, I cut it at 30 millimeters. With one finger, you can push about 15 or 16 pounds, and this just slides underneath, so I know that that's the right clearance. And make sure that the track clips are even on both sides, and make sure that the track is running square on the skid frame, on the sliders. To adjust the track tension, you'll need 215 millimeters for the axle and a 10 millimeter to adjust track tension. You wanna tighten these 10 millimeter bolts. Make sure you do equal on both sides. If I'm doing three on here and I start right at the belt and end at the belt, I'll go to this side, do the same thing. Three there, down to the belt, and maybe it's five turns, however it is. Double check your alignment, tighten the jam nuts, just snug. And when you're looking at the sliders, you wanna make sure that they're pretty uniform. The thickness will be about 25 millimeters, and your highest point of wear is roughly about where the center shock bolts into the rails. So if you look at it, you can see this is the curvature. This area here is the highest wear point. So keep an eye on that. When you pull up next to your buddy and they're getting on and off the sled and it's squeaking when they stand on it, it's because they never seen one of these. Grease gun. There's only a couple grease zerks in here. Don't be shy, give them some attention. Just keep pumping the grease gun until you see the grease come out on the end of the shaft. There's one on the rear triangle, and there's two up here on the front arm. Really easy to get at, really easy to maintain. Show them some love. So when you do all these pre-season checks, it's gonna save you time and money once you get out on the snow. And your sled will perform awesome, and you're gonna have more fun. Hope you folks learned a few things. I can't wait to see you out on the snow, and have a great season.